Yesterday, OpenAI has presented a new version of ChatGPT, CHATGPT-4o. I can tell you one thing, it has left me speechless, especially this part.
Okay, Bot Gaskar wants to know if GPT-4o is capable of real-time translation. Mark, you want to try this one?
Sure, yeah, let's do it.
Right. Yeah. I speak Italian, so we can just do English-Italian.
Let's try to do English-Italian. Sure, let's do it. Hey, ChatGPT, how are you?
I'm doing fantastic. Thanks for asking. How about you? How's your day going?
I'm doing great. So I would like you to function as a translator. I have a friend here who only speaks Italian, and I only speak English. And every time you hear English, I want you to translate it to Italian. And if you hear Italian, I want you to translate it back to English. Is that good?
Perfetto.
Mark, io mi chiedo se le balene potessero parlare, cosa ci direbbero?
Mike, she wonders if whales could talk, what would they tell us?
They might ask, how do we solve linear equations?
Potrebbero chiederci, come risolviamo le equazioni lineari?
Sicuramente, sì.
Certainly, yes.
Great, looks like it works.
I think the significance of this moment will be gradually dawning on us. But what we have just seen basically means one simple thing. There is no more such thing as languages. There is no more language divide. Starting from now, any person on this planet can talk to any other person. Ability to speak and to communicate is what made us humans, humans. But since the first sapiens pronounce his or her first word, each group of people, each tribe was creating its own language, and unable to communicate, people were isolated. And here's an extreme example, Papua New Guinea. This small island in the middle of nowhere in Pacific has more than 800 languages. And these are not just dialects, these are languages. And most of them are different from each other, as different as, for example, a Japanese and Italian. So, since the early days, our world was separated, was divided, but not anymore. Starting from yesterday, there are effectively no more languages. We all speak one language. How should it make us feel? And here's my take on this. Here's how I personally feel about it. So, I have three main thoughts about it. The first feeling is excitement and relief, because we finally will be able to complete the Babel Tower. Well, metaphorically, of course, but nevertheless, complete the Babel Tower. Starting from yesterday, the world will have much less miscommunications. And miscommunications, starting from the Babel Tower time, miscommunications brought a lot of problems and suffering in this world. For example, and I have a personal example here, as you know, for some time I was a columnist for Forbes, a Forbes columnist. And back then Forbes was an American company, and it was before it was acquired by China. So I also was writing for the Moscow office of Forbes, and I was writing from China. I was covering China, including tech and AI. So I was basically writing for a Russian office of an American company from China. So I wrote about overall about 25 articles over the course of 4 years. And it so happens that that was a period of tectonic shifts between the global powers, between the US, China and Russia. And as a journalist who speaks all three languages, I happened to attend many events. And here's what I found. Almost half of escalations and deterioration in relationships between the countries, all those events, all those escalations that we all have observed, so probably about a half of them were caused by miscommunications, were caused by a lost in translation effect. And here's my favorite example. It's a historical meeting of Trump and Putin in Helsinki in 2018. Before we go further, I have to make it very clear that I'm not a fan of anybody whom we see on the screen who was on that stage. Okay, so now as we have made this disclaimer, let's go back to Helsinki. So back then, as you may remember, the most discussed, the most acute topic in the world was alleged meddling of Russia in the US election. Was Russia influencing or interfering with American elections or not? And here's what happened on that historical meeting. A journalist asked the question.
President Putin, did you want President Trump to win the election, and did you direct any of your officials to help him do that?
Да, я хотел, чтобы он выиграл. Потому что он говорил о нормализации российско-американских отношений.
So the journalist asked two questions. President Putin, did you want the President Trump to win the elections? And did you direct any of your officials to do that? These were two different questions. It's important, two different questions. And Putin replied, да, я хотел, чтобы он выиграл. Потому что он говорил о нормализации американо-российских отношений. What this means is, yes, I wanted him to win, because he was talking about normalization of the Russian-American relationships. And here's what the translator said. Listen carefully, because every word is important here.
Потому что он говорил о нормализации российско-американских отношений.
Yes, I did. Yes, I did. Because he talked about bringing the US-Russian relationship back to normal. Basically, the translator made it sound like Putin answered yes twice. As if Putin had answered both questions, as he answered yes to both questions. While in fact, he answered only one question, the second question, about bringing the officials to do that. So it was a false translation, lost in translation. And the media around the world picked it up, echoed, escalated, magnified that false translation. And we all know what happened then. Again, I'm not defending anybody who was on that stage, but it is clear that the information here was distorted. It was lost in translation. And there were many, many cases like this. Well, less pivotal, less exposed to the media, less consequential, but still significant. My point here is that the relationships between groups of people, especially large groups of people like countries, these relationships always been complicated, made complex by the language barrier. It's a Babel Tower effect, just like the Bible says, right? So starting from yesterday, that language barrier is gone. This is why I feel relieved. But at the same time, I feel sad about ChatGPT, ChatGPT-4o. Because until now, the world was a collection of unique, interesting places and cultures. It was so interesting to explore. But now, with one language for all of us, will it be like a McDonald's effect when suddenly all downtowns in the world began, or basically all restaurants in the world began to look the same? So will all cities, all countries, the entire world, will it suddenly start look the same just as it happened with McDonald's? Well, I don't want to be a harbinger of bad news here, but I think that's what will happen. And then the third feeling that I personally feel I have about ChatGPT-4o, that's pain. Because it so happens that I have spent a substantial part of my life learning languages. Besides Russian, Chinese and English, I also speak, French and German. Well, at least I can pretend that I speak them. And yesterday I learned that it doesn't matter anymore, that that all that effort was written off. Just think about it. Who will even want to learn a foreign language after yesterday, right? But that being said, if you net it all out, I feel excited. Because starting from yesterday, we will live in a new world. And something tells me that this will be a very interesting place.